3, 4. Rev up your engine. All right, today I'm going to show a 96 Corvette. A lot of guys are looking for Corvettes. They think, oh, they're too expensive or they're all junk. Well, this one was recently picked up for only $7,000. There's still good deals out there. Mind you, it was from a 70-year-old man, so you're taking less of a risk than you are if you're buying it from a 25-year-old. Check it out. It's still got the original paint job on it. Some guys really take care of these things, and if you can find one like this, let me tell you, buy it. When you check the interior, it's all original. Yeah, there's a few scratches, a little pitting. That shows it's original. It's worth more money that way. You don't want it with all this aftermarket stuff. The seats are still in decent shape. Now, these things are a lot tougher than you might think because the owner recently hit a deer here in Tennessee. He just bent stuff up, and then he decided, well, he's going to put some LED headlights in anyway, so he did that. But, hey, a solid car. Some of these modern cars, you hit a deer, you can say goodbye to the car. I even had a customer in Texas hit a deer with this big old 250 truck. You know, all the cooling systems they got in the front, power steering, automatic transmission, you name it. All those coolers were destroyed. It did over $6,000 worth of damage, and that was a big old truck. It's one advantage of being lower and aerodynamic. Things can hit, but then they can slide right off. It didn't even ruin his windshield. Now, the one real fun thing about Corvettes are you can kind of mold them to your amount of money you want to spend. Yeah, you're not going to probably go out and buy one. They only made 2 that year or 8 that year. They're going to cost a fortune. This is a collector's one. They made about 5,000 of these. They all got plenty of power. You don't have to go buy one that costs a small fortune. You can find plenty of them out there that are in excellent shape, a lot of fun to drive, and over time, this one certainly is going to appreciate in value. The original paint job, original hood. Heck, it's even got the original wheels, and they're still in excellent shape. Now, the main reason people buy these vehicles is because of the engine. It's an American V8. This particular one puts out around 340 horsepower. They have tons of power. They're fun to drive, and they're classic rear-wheel drive. So, of course, they're great for drifting, doing donuts with their setup. They're kind of like really fun giant go-karts. Now, some people, they don't like the crawling in and then crawling out, but that's part of the fun, and that's part of why they ride so well, because they're so low, which is what you want. Now, this being a 96, it's a lot of fun to drive, but it's more of a man's car. They ride like a go-kart too. If you remember the one I did on the new CA with a mid-engine car, that had the magnet track suspension, and when you put it on sport, it handles even tighter than this. But when you put it on the touring, it actually rode like an old Cadillac. It was very smooth. So, you know, they've got ways to get around this, but this is a serious driving car. If you're the type of person that wants to drive serious, you can have a lot of fun. But it's not a car that is a comfy long distance car. A lot of people think, oh, I'll get that, and then they don't like it. So if you want that, you're gonna have to get a newer one. You're not gonna get a classic. Now, the cool thing about these Vets are you can do whatever you want. This has the stock 4L50 transmission in it. Shifts perfectly fine. Do whatever you want to do. But if you want to upgrade, go ahead. Do whatever you want. If you're half insane, put a supercharger blower on it if you want. You can do whatever you want. Plenty fast enough the way it is. And for $7,000, you get one in this kind of shape, you can have an awful lot of fun. Now, yeah, it's an older car, but hey, it's got a new auto lock on it. That's kind of a crazy thing. It may be old, but it's still very stylish. And once you're in the seats, they really hold you in. They're comfortable, yet form-fitting. And this particular one, as you can see over the steering wheel, this baby's only got 92,000 miles on it. There's a ton of life left in this car. And of course, just listen to it. The burble and the fury. If you really wonder why people drive these, this is why. And when you you get into twisties, this car is really fun. With these wide tires and the suspension system, it just handles like a dream. It is not a sedan to piddle down the road in. It's, they have a lot of fun in. Now after that ride, you can understand how they sold more than 1.5 million Corvettes. Now yes, when they're new, they're not cheap, but hey, you find one that an old man owned? Now he's got it straight pipe, so it sounds better, but when he bought it, it had the stock exhaust on it. And that kind of proves if you're looking at one, if you can find one with the stock exhaust, say you want more noise. Doesn't matter, you're better off with the stock exhaust knowing, they didn't drive it like a lunatic, they didn't push it to its limit. If you want to, take it off and straight pipe it. It's actually better to buy one that isn't straight pipe because odds are it's been driven more conservatively. Granted, there are 70-year-old men that drive like lunatics too, but your odds are in your favor if you buy it from an older person than if you buy it from somebody who's 20-something years old who's gonna be ragging the heck out of it. Of course, being fiberglass, you don't have to worry about the rust factor. Most places, these things hold up quite well over the years as long as they're not wrecked or just driven too hard. This one wasn't. You can drive it hard now. Not that many cars you can go out and buy a 96 that drive like this. There just aren't that many. They've been taken care of. This one is. And really, if you can find one like this with the original paint job still on it, hey, it's only going to appreciate in value if you don't wrap it around a tree. It's a fun car for a very small amount of money if you use your head and look at it from a logical standpoint. This particular one was found on Facebook. His father found it. He knows a lot about cars. His father owns a bunch of these. They got a good deal on a really nice car. Check out the LED headlights. He put them on since the deer whacked one of them. You can modify them to your heart's content. You can do little ones, big ones, whatever you want to do. They're a lot of fun, and it's not all that expensive unless you start getting into beefing up the engine, throwing superchargers on them. But as you saw in that ride, these things are pretty quick the way they're set up originally. If you want just a fun, fast car, you could leave it the way it is. It's not like it's some wimpy little V6 that you gotta push the heck out of it to get some power. It's already got plenty of power in it. Now, if you're totally insane, you can do like the Callaway Sledgehammer, and that C4 Corvette went 254 miles an hour. So, that'll show you, you got a pretty solid base here that you can play with if you really want to go insane. But for $7,000, I can't think of much that you can have this much fun in. If you can find one in this kind of shape from an old man, even if you got tired of it, as long as you don't wrap it around a tree, you can probably make money selling it on to somebody else. You're certainly not going to lose any money. Because when you think about it, one of the worst investments you could ever make is buying a brand new car. It doesn't matter what it is. If you pay 60 grand for a nice car when it's 5-6 years old, hey, you're lucky probably if you're going to get 10 or 15 for it used. If you get this whole thing for $7,000 in this kind of shape, man, you can't go wrong. And since this is Tennessee, you can straight pipe it all you want. You don't have to worry about any stinking federal emissions. They don't test that stuff here. You can just drive and have some fun in a really nice car for a really small amount of money if you spend your time and do a little research. But that sound, the sound, it's priceless. It's the sound of America. The way it used to be in my younger days. Like I said, I've been reborn here in Tennessee, and I'm a happy man. And here's some bonus questions and answers. Neil McDavid says, I'm looking at a 2001 Ford Expedition with 280,000 miles for $2,200, 4x4. Should I look for one with fewer miles? Can I use this? Will it last a while? It was a one-owner car. It looks like it's in good shape. Well, you know, normally I would never buy a Ford Expedition with 280,000 miles. They're great vehicles when they're new. As they age, they have all the high-tech gizmos and gadgets, and they all break as time goes on. But if you don't care about all those gizmos, and this really was a one-owner car, they're the only people that owned it, and the mechanic checks it and says engine and tranny still in good shape, go ahead. Just don't think you're going to drive it another 280,000 miles trouble-free. You're going to spend a lot of money. If you want something to kind of toy around with, a little bit here, a little bit there, you could gamble with it. It's only $2,200. You realize what a new one costs, 20, 30 times that, you know? So, what the heck? If it is in good shape, it's one owner, you want a car to have for a weekend, do some stuff with, but don't get it as an everyday driver. That would be a mistake. I've had people do that, and then it nickel and dimes them to death, and then they just give up with it. But maybe it's a second vehicle. It could be okay, seeing that it was one owner vehicle. So if you never want to miss another one of my new car repair videos, remember to ring that bell.